Hey, welcome to ParkTV 16 and our latest production of high school sports in St. Louis Park in the year 2017. Tonight, we are bringing you a broadcast from Groves Academy, where the varsity boys basketball team is hosting the Heritage Academy Hawks. This is an interconference game. As anyone that's watching, I'm sure knows, Groves Academy is part of the brand new Twin Cities Athletic Conference. And when we look at their standings, they are not doing so well this year. They are 0-8 in the conference, 1-15 overall. And they are taking on a team, Heritage Academy Hawks, and they are part of the Minneapolis North Community High School Conference, and they come in with a 6-5 record. So they're going against a 0-8, a 1-15 Groves Academy, but they do have one win. We broadcasted here once before. They do have some talented players to watch. One in particular, they're about to announce him here in the starting lineups. You'll see him here in a second. He's a big, tall kid, and he can play.
For the Griffins, at forward 6'6", freshman number 15, Max Bilsick.
And that's the guy, Bilsick. Keep an eye on him. Max Gilsick is a ninth grader. He's 6'6", and the kid can shoot.
At center for Groves, 6'3", junior, number 52, Max Riesel. For the Hawks, at guard, 5'5", freshman, number 4, Ahmed Aiden.
Keep an eye on Mr. Quinn. When we were broadcasting the last time we were here, he was an effective player. So between Quinn and Bilsick, those are the two kids that could, if there's gonna be a win tonight for Groves Academy, those two kids are gonna play well. They're the most talented on that team, and they're the ones to keep an eye on. They have their work cut out though. Against Heritage Academy, they play in a tougher conference, and they're also 6-5. So it'll be interesting to see how it turns out tonight. So there's something going on that I'm unfamiliar with here. They're starting out with free throws. I'm not exactly. There was an explanation, and unfortunately I did not understand it or hear it, actually. I wasn't listening. So we have number 12 at the free throw line for Heritage Academy Hawks. And he misses two shots. I'm not sure what that was all about, if there was a technical foul during the warm-ups. We'll have to get some clarification on that. But nevertheless, there's still 18 minutes to go in the first half, and Quinn is gonna take side out, and he's gonna throw it into Bilsick, and we're underway. Finally, Groves Academy. I, honest to God, do not know what that free throw stuff was all about, but I am determined to find out. I've never seen like that. There's Bilsick, big three off the top of the rim. Rebound, number 21, that's Abdurrahim Musa, and he comes down and makes the shot. Nice job. And there's a nice shot by number 12, Ibrahim Mohammed. And it's 2-2 early on here. Nice start for Groves Academy. There's a move inside by number 12, Ibrahim Mohammed. Foul on Groves Academy. Two shots for Mr. Mohammed, and that first shot is in. Nice follow through, good form by the young lad. Off the rim, rebound Bilsik, and he brings the ball down quick on the left side. Looking for a lane, he passes it off. To number 12, that was Malik Bowden with the miss, and then he gets the steal and the layup, and he was not here last time. And so that bodes well for Groves Academy. He is a nice player. So with him, Quinn Bilsik, and the other folks, they got a nice little team here. Let's see what happens tonight. Shot off the mark. That was Shamarki Abdi with the miss. There's Baden again. Out of bounds to Heritage Academy. That's number one, Mohammed. Mohammed bringing the ball up over to number 12, Ibrahim Mohammed. Dribbles left, throws out, big shot, number 21, and he nails it. That is Abdurrahman Musa, a senior forward. Nice shot by that young man. 6'4", Heritage. This Bilsik at the top of the key. Nice bounce pass in below. I think he may have traveled. Or they called the foul. What is it gonna be? Yeah, they think they called the travel. Just shuffled his feet. Nice pass in there to number 23. Noah Madsen. Another nice player for Groves Academy. Driving on that play was Moosey. Drew the foul before the shot, so inbounds pass by Heritage Academy. Mohammed in to number 4, Aden, and out to Mohammed, and off the mark, out of bounds. Groves Academy ball. It's Malik Bowden running the show. He's their point guard. Very poised out there. Oh, almost gets the ball stolen, and they call a foul on number 4 for Heritage. Ahmed Aden, a ninth grader. Side out, Groves Academy. It's Heritage's second team foul. There's a pass into Bilsik, and he gets his first points with the left-handed layup and ties it up with 15 minutes to go here in the first half. Here comes Abdurrahim Musa, and a big shot. He passes off to number 23, Shamarki Abdi. And he drains it from the right side. A 3-9-6 Heritage. There's Baden inside to Bilsik, and another left-handed layup. That's the combination right there. 9-8. Nice move there by Ibrahim Mohammed. Nice drive, switches hands. There's Botten. Setting things up. Botten, that's B-O-D. Oh, there's a big shot by Bilsik off the mark. Gets his own rebound. Nice follow-up by him. Another shot off the mark. Saved by Quinn. intercepted by Muhammad, and they have a fast break 4-on-2, and Muhammad takes it all the way and scores. There was a little bit of body contact, no call on that. And here comes Bodden just right down, and we call a foul. Side out. Third team foul for Heritage. Quinn throwing the ball into Bilsik, and he lets it go from way outside the three-point line, and he nails it. 11-13. Ooh, might have been a little travel there. Wow, nice dribbling. Oh, foul. Touch call. Questionable. Bodden. Let's see here. Look at that shot by Bilsik. I mean, he is, look how he's way out there. That's NBA three-point line. He is not shy. Good for him. Ninth grader, keep shooting. Nice rebound there by number 23, Noah Madsen. Bodden now bringing the ball up. Bilsik to his right. Drives the lane. Whistle, shot off the mark, and it looks like we're gonna get a foul on that on Heritage Academy. Two shots for Mr. Bodden. A chance to tie it up. Here in the first half, Groves Academy, we saw them about a month ago, and they have markedly improved. Good basketball game here so far. Nice shot by Bodden. Got the bounce. And he nails that second one, and we got a tie game here with 13:37 to go. And Heritage brings the ball up quickly. Oh, we got a travel. Good call by the referee. Number 12 for Heritage was a little quick. That was Ibrahim Mohammed. Took a step before he dribbled. That's traveling. Bodden, we got a new player in here for Groves Academy. That's number 14, Larry Mohammed. Sophomore, 5'7 guard. Bodden tries to save it on the outside and a foul on Bilsik. Oh, unfortunate for him. Not the kind of foul you want to get. But it's only his first, I believe. Just kind of got caught in the wrong position there. Nick Lang is number one for Heritage with the ball and the drive and the whistle. We got a foul. Before, two shots he's calling. And he'll be at the line. Nick Lang, seventh grader. 5'2 guard. At the line. Got a second one coming. That ball is in and out. Rebound by Muhammad and a nice turnaround jump shot. That was sweet looking. Nice move by that young man, number 21 for Heritage. Abdurrahim Moussa. Both teams have five team fouls. They get to the bonus on number 7. Here's Bodden now. Under 13 minutes to go. Takes the shot on the drive. Muhammad with the long pass to number 15. Abdurrahman Muhammad. Off his hands. Groves Academy ball. And Bodden bringing it up. And a trap attempt by Heritage, and it works. They get the turnover. That's Muhammad, number 21, Moussa. And he is playing point guard, passes it over to number 22, lets it go, and it's off the rim, rebound to Quinn, and Groves Academy, down by two. Bodden brings the ball up, drives the middle, pass to Noah, and he takes the shot off the mark. Muhammad the rebound, ahead to number 15, and they call the foul and the block, and two shots will be coming to number 15, Abdirahman Muhammad, a junior guard for Heritage. Here it is, and he just gets him. Oh yeah, nice camera angle there. Not a bad foul to take for number 14. Make him earn it at the line. Second shot, nice follow through. These kids are getting really nice training with their shots, just the way they follow through with their wrists. It's a sign that they've been trained well. All right. There's Quinn with his first shot tonight, off the mark. Rebound goes to Heritage, ahead to Nick. He does a turn, oh, that's gotta be a travel there, and there is. That was a nice turnaround jump shot though, or whatever, turnaround layup. Harlem Globetrotter's worthy, but he traveled, so it's not gonna count. So Heritage has opened up a 4-point lead here, nearing the halfway point of the first half. There's Quinn, a nice play there. Nice give and go by Noah for Groves. Pass it to Quinn, and a nice layup there. That's Nick Lang moving middle, and turnover. Goes to Groves Academy, a chance to tie it here with 11:10 to go. Here's the replay. And they just called it out of bounds on Heritage. Timeout on the floor. Good first half, not a lot of fouls. Tight game here. Groves just down two, coming into this game with just one win on the year against a solid Heritage Academy Hawks team, playing in a much tougher conference. 6-5 record. And Groves is looking very, very good tonight. Looking ahead on the Minnesota State High School League schedule. If you're interested in the state tournament, it's gonna be coming up here next month, March 22nd through the 25th. The games in all classes will be played at either Target Center, Williams Arena, or the U of M, or Concordia over in St. Paul. The Section 5AA tournament, if you're a Heritage fan, is gonna be the week of March 17th, St. Patrick's Day. So we're getting close to tournament time. Teams are getting better. Been playing since November. And I can definitely say that Groves Academy is looking a lot better than they looked a month ago. All right, inbounds to Groves Academy. They're down two, 11 minutes to go, first half. That's Bodden with the ball. They're trying to double team him, and they got a push call on number 15. And that's what it looked like. He's harassing him there just a little bit. Ball goes back to Groves. A couple of turnovers real quick there, and still Groves ball down two. Bottom behind the back dribble, trying to find a lane, gets pushed to the side. Nice pass to Noah, but I think he walked. Yeah. Just took that extra step there. Getting a little anxious, he knew he was close to scoring. With experience, he'll get better at that. Here's Nick Lang, number one. Passes off to number 15, Abdiram Mohammed. And there's a shot. Foul called away from the play, it looks. And we will have a, yeah, inbounds play. The foul was not on the shot, it was away from the action. 23 a block. Oh, maybe they will call that on the shooting. I guess they are. I see. They are in the bonus, producer Paul Broden pointed out. So that's why they're going to the line. Some moisture on the court there. The coach for Groves coming out there. A coach's job is multifaceted. Abdurrahim Musa at the line. Swish. Nice form on this young man's shot. Three dribbles, shoot, bang. Nice job. 4-point lead for Heritage. Here comes Baden, passes it down to number 14. Larry Muhammad, and the shot by Noah Madsen off the mark. And the pass ahead on the break to Nick Lang, and that he misses. And a nice play there by number 12. Ibrahim Muhammad gets the rebound and sees Nick Lang out of the corner of his eye. Nice pass and 2 points, 6-point lead for Heritage, and they have the ball again with another break. Layup off the mark, rebound though by Heritage. Abdi with that, pass down below. Now out to Nick Lang, passes on the shot, nice pass in there. What a beautiful play there by Nick Lang. Faked the three-pointer, dribbled, and then saw Sharmarki Abdi with the pass and the bucket. Groves comes down, misses. This is a dangerous time for Groves. Heritage is on a bit of a run. There's Nick Lang, he passes on the three-pointer again, dribbles, passes to Muhammad, who drives the bucket, and it's a swish, and timeout. Wisely taken. Groves Academy down by 10. And that last sequence showed Heritage going on a run. 4 or 5 baskets in a row. Groves Academy unable to convert on their times down the court. And there you have your 10-point deficit in this match. Here's the replay. There's Nick. He fakes that three and that nice pass. That was a beautiful camera angle there. And that was a beautiful play by Nick Lang. Real smooth. Underhand pass right into number 23. And he knows what to do with it. And that's your 10-point lead for Heritage. There's the other replay. Look at that drive. Just great body control by that kid, Muhammad. Right, 9 minutes, 5 seconds to go here in the first half. Groves ball down 10. They called timeout. Let's see if they can get in on this, reduce this 10-point deficit they're facing suddenly. Boy, aggressive defense by Nick Lang on Baden, and they do call the foul. Wait a minute. Oh, they called it on Baden. I can't believe it. Really? Watch this. Huh? He harasses him. He harasses him. And then he calls the foul on that? No way. Oh, nice steal there. And a nice convert. What a play. That might turn things around. for Groves Academy. Here's a guy that came to play, Larry Mohammed, the sophomore 5'7 guard, steals and converts. And there's another steal by Bott. And here comes Groves Academy and another layup. Here they come, four in a row. That was a horrible call before. That might spark Groves Academy. It's Mohammed with the jump and the ball bounces in. That shows a lot of wisdom there. He just lets the ball float up there and it bounces in. Here comes Bodden, nice move on Lang. He's being pressured, they're double teaming. There's Quinn, lets it go, and it's good for a three. I told you at the beginning, he's a guy to look out for too. Quinn and Bilsik, who's on the bench. Groves just down five. Under 8 minutes to play, first half. There's Mohammed, number 21, Nick Lang. He's wily, there's Mohammed. Lang. Looking for an opening. Good defense by Groves. It's number 23, and the shot is made. Whistle, and a foul's called for a three-point play. That was Shamarki Abdi. There it is. I don't know if there was much of a foul there. I guess there was. Shamarki Abdi. Senior guard. Lefty. Ball rattles out, but the offensive rebound by Mohammed, stellar, and then the rebound by number 12, Ibrahim Mohammed, takes the ball back up, foul, and two shots. That's the 10th team foul on Groves, so it'll be the double bonus from here on out in the first half. Any foul called, whether it's shooting or not, is gonna go to the line for an automatic two. Makes that one, and it's an 8-point lead, largest lead of the night for Heritage. Groves still showing some life. Boy, they're double teaming him, and it works, and they cause the turnover. Groves needs to come up with an answer for that. Heritage's strategy is they know Bodden is good, and he brings the ball up, and the minute he crosses the half court line, they double team him, and they try to box him in, and they don't have a plan to answer that. Shot by 31. Robert Hall for Groves, the ninth grade guard, blocked, side out, Quinn throwing it in, brings it out to Bodden. Goes right by Nick Lang. Oh, intercepted, and ball goes to Groves Academy. Bodden drives to center, dish off. Oh, nice give and go there from Hall, from Bodden to Hall, back to Bodden. 6-point deficit. Mohammed driving like a point guard. Layup off, passes it out to Lang, steps in, passes on the shot. Over to Mohammed, drives the lane, ball off his thigh, whistle. Not sure what the call is. Foul on 23, Noah Madsen. Two shots, because they're in the double bonus. Mr. Bilsik is still on the sideline. Not sure why he's been there for so long. Might be in foul trouble. Mohammed misses that first shot. Here's his second. Off the front of the rim. Rebound comes back to him, though. Passes off to 23. Goes down to 12. And he makes the layup. 23, I should know his name by now. Shamarki Abdi. And Groves comes down and misses the layup, unfortunately. And back comes Heritage and the layup by number 12, Ibrahim Mohammed. And a whistle and a foul, a block. And we're now in the bonus for the first time, 17 fouls on Heritage. So Baden will at the line for a 1-1. And he misses the first shot. Rebound to Muhammad, out to Shakari, to Lang inside, and nice pass. Lang has nice vision there. He's real quick to see who is available, and he saw Ibrahim Mohammed, and he got the two for a 12-point lead, the biggest lead of the night for Heritage. There's Sharp Markey Abdi, and he misses the layup. Whistle, foul on 21 Mohammed, and a 1-1. If Groves wants to get back in this game, they got to start making their 1-1s. So Noah Madsen is at the line, shooting 1-1. The senior 6'1 forward. Off the rim, rebound goes to Ibrahim Mohammed, and he dishes off to Sharmarki Abdi, who makes the layup. Nice fast break off the missed free throw. And now another turnover by Baden. Here comes Heritage in over to number 15, Adiraman Mohammed with the two and a 14-point lead. 5 minutes to go. Here comes Quinn with the jump shot, gets his own rebound, goes up, and they call a travel. Turnover, ball to Heritage Academy. Off the mark by Lang. Rebound Mohammed, and here comes Baden on the right side. 1-on-3 break, what a move. Oh, he called travel there? I'm not so sure. That was a travel. Let's see. Bang, dribble, bang. No way, that is not a travel. That was a nice move there. He just couldn't believe how much real estate he made up. That was not a travel. Too bad for Groves. Anyway, they're down 16, 4 minutes, 11 seconds to go. Hey, there's Bill Sick back in the game, gets the rebound and a foul, and he'll go to the line shooting 1-1. This will be their third 1-1 since going in the bonus. They've converted 0 of those shots. That's 6 points. They'd just be down 10 if they had made those. Those are free points without time going off the clock. If you're down double digits, it's a great way to get back in the game. Gotta make free throws. Nice shot there by Mr. Bilsick. He's been down for a while. Let's see if he can do some damage here with 4 minutes to go. Cut into this Heritage Academy double digit lead. And that second shot, but the rebound goes to Noah Madsen, and he puts it back up. Oh, unfortunately, that poor kid. The ball has just not been dropping for him. He made a nice offensive rebound and a put back there, and the ball just didn't go in. There is no justice in the world. All right, here comes Bilsick. Nice steal, gets the Baden, and oh, off the rim, unfortunately. Ball back down the court to Ibrahim Mohammed, the junior, converts. No poetic. Now there's a foul on Heritage and another one-on-one for Groves. Bodden to the line. Nice shot there by Mr. Bodden. Malik Jr., 5'10 guard. And makes a second. Nice looking shot there. A lot of these kids have been trained very well on how to shoot that basketball. All right, there is Bilsick. And there's a shot. Boom. Wow. Robert Hall, the ninth grader, delivers. Shot from the side. And nice rebound by number 21, Abdurrahman Moussa. Ball back down, and Hall takes a shot, gets blocked. Bilsick steals it. And, oh, ball saved by Lang and stolen again. And here comes Bodden, one on two, and his layup gets blocked by Muhammad, and they come racing down the court the full length, and he loses it underneath the basket to number 12, Ibrahim Muhammad, who takes the shot and the whistle. Yikes. Look at the action here. Nice shot there by Hall. Nice replay. Robert Hall, he's got a nice shot there. Boy, Grove's got some talent here. Nice follow through there by Ibrahim Muhammad. And another beautiful looking shot. Look at that follow through. Very impressive. Okay, we have a full court man-to-man press. And Groves beats it big time. And Quinn with the shot. Bilsick with the rebound off the mark. Rebound Muhammad ahead to Shamarki Abdi. The whistle, and out of bounds to Groves Academy. Bilsick will bring the ball up, throws it down to Hall, goes in to Noah Madden, and a whistle, and a foul, and another one-on-one opportunity, but now we're in the double bonus, which means Noah Madsen's gonna get two shots. And we got a whistle and a timeout on the court. With 2:15 to go here in the first half, 46-30 is your score. The game started out mostly close until the mid-teens. It was like 17-15, and then that's when Heritage started to extend their lead on a more permanent basis. They were up by 6-8 for a while, and then it slowly increased here to 16. Groves makes an answer, but not ever quite enough to get right back with them. But they've got some nice players out there with Bodden, Bilsick, Hall, Madden at the line, but you gotta make the free throws. Off the mark. This will be Noah's second. Noah Madsen. And he makes that one. Nice shot. Ball quickly down. Here it is, Nick Lang over to Muhammad, over to Shamarki Abdi with the nice spin layup from the knees, left-handed. Vilsick. Muhammad with the rebound, headmans to Lang. A little too far, he saves it, back to Groves. Quinn takes the shot on the left and off the mark. Is sort of a spread offense, but nevertheless they penetrate the lane there by Shamarki. Abdi dishes off to Ibrahim Mohammed and he makes that shot. Groves Academy quickly down, misses their shot, rebound, and there's Shamarki Abdi with the reverse left-handed layup. Less than a minute, and then Lang steals the inbound pass back to Shamarki, over to Ibrahim Mohammed, and another quick two. Things are getting out of hand very quickly here, late in the first half. Here comes Bilsik, who's had enough, gets the whistle, and will go to the line, shooting two. Wow, that was quite a sequence there by Heritage Academy. They have now opened up a 23-point lead, just like that. Bilsik misses the first, but he gets a second since they're in the double bonus. The tall ninth grader lefty off the mark, but rebound goes to Madsen. Back to Bilsik with the three, and off the mark, gets his own rebound, puts it back up, and there's a foul and two shots will be awarded to Mr. Bilsik. Third miss in a row by Mr. Bilsik. He just needs to calm down. Just relax. He's got a really nice shot. He's a really nice player. There we go. There you go. It's all about being relaxed, shooting those free throws. Okay, here comes Heritage. Lang back to Shamarki Abdi. Oh, he drives, and they're going to call the charge on that. Madsen had position. Nice play by him. Clearly a charging call on Shamarki Abdi. Here comes Baden. Less than 30 seconds to go, first half. I was just gonna say Groves looking for some sort of spark to take it into halftime, but they turn it over to Shamarki, who misses the layup, and the rebound by Ibrahim Mohammed. And he makes the shot. It is fouled on the play, and he will go to the line for a 3-point play and a chance to put them up 25. And he does, 57-32. Inbounds pass by Bilsik, almost intercepted by Nick Lang. Boy, Heritage Academy, they are on top of it. They are not giving up. Still playing aggressively. Nick Lang encouraging his teammates that we're not giving up here. We're gonna play out the half, even though we're up by 25, and it pays off. They got the ball, and there's Muhammad from way out, takes the big three. Off the mark, and that is your first half here from Carolyn Groves Gymnasium in St. Louis Park, Minnesota. Halftime score, 57-32. The visiting Heritage Academy Hawks are winning.
My journey skating for the gold taught me a lot. but my journey with breast cancer has been one of my greatest teachers.
Every woman's breast cancer is unique. Be Wiser educates and empowers women to take control of their breast cancer treatment plan and help navigate their own path beyond 5 years.
Talk to your doctor about information and tests to personalize a treatment plan that fits your needs. I did. Be informed, be wiser, support survivors like us.
Welcome back to ParkTV Sports 16's broadcast of Groves Academy hosting the Heritage Academy Hawks, and we're about to begin the second half here, and the score, as you can see on your screen, 57-32. It was close early on through the first half of the first half, and then Heritage Academy got their way and started to take advantage of some turnovers and opened up a 25-point lead. And they will start with the ball on a side out. And just incidentally, if you're watching at the beginning, the game started out with free throws. And as I thought, there must have been some violation during the pregame warmups. And I did speak with the referees over the halftime break. And there's a nice shot there by Shamarki Abdi to start off the second half. There's Quinn. Nice pass down low to number 52, Max Griseth. He's been out there all game long. We need to hear from him. Back down, Nick Lang with the shot. And the miss, and there's Quinn with a nice steal. Comes down against Abdi, who's much taller, and he sneaks in that layup on the left side. Nice sneaky play there by Mr. Quinn. He took the much bigger Abdurrahman Musa, who must be 6'2", 6'3", at least. Another steal by Groves, and there's Bodden, and he makes the convert as Groves Academy is not done yet tonight. They cut the lead to 14. That's a 10-point makeup here in the first less than 2 minutes. Something happened at halftime there. And Groves is a different team. They look much more concentrated. And they've outscored Heritage here by 9 points. And there's Muhammad with a nice 3-point shot. That'll quiet it down real quick. Here comes Bodden. Nice dish off to Quinn. And he can't handle it. He's a little low. He got a little ahead of himself. He saw the angle. Here's that nice pass in there to Ibrahim Mohammed. But as I was saying before, the issue was that during the warm-ups, one of the players, and I didn't identify who it was, and there's a whistle on the call. Groves will take the ball out. Is that during the warm-ups, they touched the rim. And touching the rim is a technical foul, and that resulted in 2 shots for Groves Academy even before the clock started at the beginning of the game. So that's what that was about. You cannot touch the rim during pregame warmups. They don't want any dunks, no flashy stuff touching rims before the game starts. Not sure what the policy is behind that rule, but there's the rule. And there's a shot by Muhammad. Oh no, that's Abdurrahman Musa. Excuse me. And that ball bounces out. Rebound to Bilsik, ahead to Bodden. And he's quickly up there. And this, oh, the ball spins out. But the rebound comes off of Heritage. And it will be Groves Academy ball. Down 18, however. Quinn will be throwing it in to Bilsik in the corner, and he lets it go, and he banks it from the side. That was awesome. He banks it from a side shot. You can do that. Not sure it was planned, but you just grazed the very high part of that backboard and gave it just enough to edge it in there. Nice shot. Here comes Bodden on the turnover, and he brings it all the way to the hole and it goes off. He needs to learn to close those out. He's such a good player. Just gotta make those layups. There's Quinn off the mark. Madsen puts it in after the fourth rebound. That is persistence. And that gets a big round of applause from the home crowd. Groves Academy is very much mentally engaged in this. They are not throwing in the towel. Nice shot in between, and there's a nice rebound by Max Grisseth, and he gives it to Bilsick. He comes in and gets the foul, and he'll be shooting two at the line. Foul on Shamarki Abdi, pleading his case to the referee to no avail. There's the call, Bilsick at the line, shooting two. Off the mark. Statistically, free throws usually decide every game in basketball. Gotta make those free throws. There's Muhammad all the way in, and the left-handed layup, and in it goes. Uncontested, basically, and now there's the steal by Ibrahim Mohammed, and he gets it stolen by Bilsick, and he comes down the court running and gunning, and it's almost stolen. There's Bodden from the inside the three-point line, and he nails the shot just inside the three-point line. That's a two-pointer, but a nice shot by Bodden. Nice round of applause from the home crowd. Much appreciative. There's Shamarki with the shot. No, I'm sorry, that was Ahmed Aden, number four with the shot. Off the mark, the ninth grader. They got him as a center, but he doesn't look like a center. And you've got three guys on Bodden bringing the, somebody's gotta be open. He takes the same shot from before, Grease up the rebound, and he can't quite put it in. Boy, he was in great position. Nice job by that young man. Just couldn't get the ball to go. And now we get a foul on number 12 for the Hawks. Ibrahim Mohammed, here it is. He bangs right into, that's a foul. There's Grisseth, nice shot, and he banks it in. Nice bounce pass from Bilsick to Grisseth, and he gets his first 2 points of the game. Nice play by that man. 21-point lead now for the Heritage Hawks. Muhammad, wow, Dyson. And splicing. Ball gets knocked away, whistle, foul, side out. That's the second team foul for the Groves Academy. We got a nice school gymnasium here. And whistle on the throw-in and a turnover. It will be Heritage Hawks ball. Bounce pass into Muhammad and he traveled. Refs have done a very nice job calling the traveling calls tonight. Not always easy to see. All right, Quinn sits down for the Griffins of Groves Academy. Ball in to Madsen, number 23, down to Bodden. Out to Bilsick. Who drives the lane, goes for the thing, and he's challenged by Ibrahim Mohammed, and they come back down with Moussa. Oh, misses the layup, rebound Groves Academy, and Bilsick all the way down, intended for Bodden, but intercepted by Ibrahim Mohammed, who brings it back all the way down to number four, Ahmed Aden, who converts on the layup. And on the ensuing inbounds pass, Groves passes it out of bounds against Heritage. It'll be Groves' ball. Wow, what a sequence. 23-point lead for Heritage. And here comes Bodden, blocked. And he gets his own rebound, puts the shot back up, and the whistle, and two shots will be awarded to Mr. Bodden. Foul on Ibrahim Mohammed, the ninth grader. Bodden shooting two, and look at that nice follow through. And nice next shot for Bodden. Quickly down the court is Heritage catching Academy sleeping, but they cannot convert. Now it's Groves' ball. Here comes Bodden, tries to dish it to Madsen, but nobody was very well covered there on the left side of the basket. But the ball goes out of bounds to Groves. And that's number 14 throwing the ball to Larry Mohammed, and he gets it in to Madsen, who is fouled on the shot. He will go to the line and shoot two. Nope, my mistake, he will not go to the line. That was before the shot. There's Bodden on the side from the three-point land. No go, rebound. Ibrahim Mohammed, number 12, bringing the ball up the court. Looking for a lane, drives, and is it gonna be a block or a charge? The ball goes in on the running layup, and it looks like it's going to be a block. Nope, he called a charge. Will the basket count? So far, no. Yeah, he did call the charge. I thought that was a good call. My first inclination without looking at the replay. And the ref did call the charge. No basket on that call. Timeout on the floor, 12:15 to go. And a 21-point lead by Heritage. Looking on the screen, you see the upcoming basketball matches for the home Groves Academy Griffins. They got, well, there's our game right now, Heritage Academy of Science and Technology. Next, they've got Liberty Classical Academy. That sounds interesting. Christian Life, they play on the 16th of February, and then it's North Lakes Academy. This is a brand new conference for these small private schools that cater to special needs kids who are very, very smart, just do well in smaller environments. And this is a very, very nice school off Highway 100 in Minnetonka Boulevard, right on the frontage road. Has a nice feel to it, caring community. I certainly would never hesitate to send a kid to this school. Has a nice feel to it. They do a nice job here. It's obvious, you can feel it. All right, so coming out of the timeout, 12:15 to go. Groves throws the ball in, and there's Mr. Bodden, number 12, bringing the ball up, running the show. Off to Bilsik, that's number 14, Mohammed. And there's a new player on the court for Groves, that's number 44, Jack Lowe, a senior 6'1 forward. There's Bodden looking for something. Bilsik lets it fly from way out in three-point land. Rebound goes to Noah Madsen, and it can't go in. Rebound, Heritage. There's Nick Lang, number one, slowing it down. Gives it back to Moussa, number 21. And he dishes it to number four, Abden. And a whistle. Stoppage in play. Ball goes to Heritage Hawks. Inbound pass to number 11 for Groves. That's Ibrahim as well. And Luce makes the shot, and now ball down to number 14, Larry Mohammed, the sophomore. Boy, he looked cool, calm and collected with that shot. That was nothing for him. Nice shot by that young man. And there's the steal by Bonin, and he's looking ahead, and he's a bounce pass to Larry Muhammad, but it goes off of him, and here comes the Hawks of Heritage Academy. Nick Lang with the bounce, with the backboard. Bilsick with the rebound and sees Bonin all the way down the court. Nice vision by Bilsick to see Bonin. Hits him for the easy layup. And now, Groves is only down 19. Well, now it's back to 21. That's number 11. The nice shot there for Heritage. Bumps it back up to 21. The deficit. There's Bilsick on the left side. Lets it fly way off the mark. There's the rebound. Off the mark again for Groves. Lowe couldn't make it. Here comes the rebound. Nick Lang, two on one. The nice dish and the whistle, the foul, and the basket is made. That's number two, Zachary Bennett. The freshman, 5'11" guard, takes the dish from Nick Lang, makes the shot, fouled, and a three-point play. A chance to push the lead back up to 24. Lane violation on Heritage, so whether he had made it or not, it would not have counted. Less than 10 minutes to go, second half. And there's a foul, number 11 push on Ibrahim, number 11. Side out, that is the sixth team foul on Heritage Academy. Bilsick throws it into bottom. Back to Bilsick, over to Quinn, into Redkin, and he makes the shot! Reset! Third and fourth point, two in a row for that man. Nice job. To the right place, took the pass, turned around, made a nice shot. And there's Mousse. The big shot. The tall, lanky kid. Abdurrahman Mousse misses the shot. Heritage's ball underneath. There's Griseth. Nice job by that man. There's Mousse. The crossover dribble and the left-handed layup drive down the middle. Beautiful play by Mousse there. Bumps it back up to a 23-point lead. Down to Bilsick in the corner, lets it fly off the mark. Griseth, and he's hammered, it'll go to the line. Max Griseth with the big offensive rebound, hangs in there. He's made his last two shots, going to the line, and yes. Nice job by number 52. Six-foot-three junior center at the line, shooting two. And he makes the first one for his fifth point. He's on a roll. It's his third shot in a row. First he made two field goals for four. And now at the line, his third shot, now his fourth. And he just bounces off. Here comes Heritage, and they get a little ahead of themselves. Turn it over again, and Bonin converts. Cuts the lead to 20, less than 9 minutes to go, second half. Can Groves Academy get back in this match? Not when they're gonna allow Mousse to do that two times in a row. He's got great body control, that kid. Gotta stop him from doing that. Here's Bot at the top of the key, and he lets it go from three-point land. Off the mark, Griseth missed the rebound, but there's Quinn with the turnaround jump shot, rebound, off the mark again. Quinn gets the rebound, out to Bonin. Looks down over to the left, that is Muhammad. And there's Griseth with the shot, and he nails it! The kid is super hot! Three field goals in a row for number 52, Max Griseth. Lead is just 20 now for Groves Academy. What a nice second half for Max Griseth. And the turnover, ball goes back to Groves. 3 for 3 in the second half. In the second half, Max Grieseth has got 7 points all in the second half. Largely responsible for the cut in the deficit. Miss there. Here comes Moussa. They gotta stop the ball. There's Nick Lang. He lets it fly from three-point land, and he converts. You know, he was faking those early on. You wonder if those are real fakes, but he's the real deal. He made that three. Nice shot. That silenced the crowd big time. Here comes Bilsik on the left side with the left, and off the backboard. Nice shot. He is like Pete Maravich from the 70s, the New Orleans Jazz. He shot those balls from his knees. And there's Nick Land with the second in a row answering back. Now neither team can miss. And tough defense by Lang. Ball out of bounds on the whistle, back to Groves Academy. Look at that shot. Oh my goodness. And he gives the little gun salute, you bet. Quinn throwing the ball in. Down to Bilsik in the corner, guarded closely by Moussa. Whistle, and ball goes to Groves. Closely guarded by number 11, Ibrahim. It's Quinn quickly into Bilsik, lets it fly off the rim. Rebound to Larry Mohammed, off the rim. Rebound, Moussa ahead to Shikari, all alone. And it converts the two. And here comes Bilsik quickly down to Baden. Run and gun both teams, and Bilsik lets it fly off the rim, and a nice jump. Rebound by Quinn. Big round of applause. He jumped to get the rebound and put it up without coming back down. Very nice job by Mr. Quinn. 24-point lead for Heritage, however. There's Shikari over to Moussa. Loves to drive the ball. Back over across court to Shikari. Looking to drive the lane. Back to Moussa. He drives the lane. Whistle and travel is the call. Turnover. Ball to Groves Academy. Mr. Baden bringing the ball up. Off to Bilsik, tries to find Noah Madsen down below. Was covered, and there's Shakarari. Shamarki Abbey off on that shot. Here's Baden, tries to dish to Madsen. Ball off of Heritage. Groves ball. Quinn to throw it in, less than 6 minutes to go. Ball remains with Groves. Quinn into Baden on the left side. Dribbling, looking. Being guarded closely by Ibrahim. Over to Larry Mohammed, number 14, back to Baden. Being closely guarded, drives him. And he gets the nice drive, the layup, and the foul for a possible three-point play. Look at that nice move there. Play point guard and the guy gets on you that close, you gotta take him on the dribble, and that's exactly what Baden did, and it paid off. Off the rebound, but Madsen with the rebound, and Baden decides to shoot again. Oh, too bad, just missed it, off the mark. That's Ahmed Aden, number 4. To Shamarki Abdi, and he gives it over to number 4, Ahmed Aden. The ninth grader nails the three, and he gets his team up to 90. Here comes Baden with the drive to the middle, and he's hit with the body on the shot. He'll get two. Look at that shot, bang. Kids like to run and gun in this league, I'll tell you what. Lots of offense. off the rim. Shamarki Abdi with the rebound. Takes it the length of the court all the way. You cannot let him do that. It's a cardinal rule when you play defensive basketball. You got to stop the ball. Who's ever bringing it up every time? Make him pass it. There's a foul on number 0, who's now into the game for the Heritage Academy Hawks. That's Mustafa Mohammed. His first personal foul. And at the line is Noah Madsen. Off the mark there. Second attempt. Off the mark again. Rebound goes to Bilsik, though. He takes it in, tries the layup, and they call a travel on him. A lot of talent on the floor. Just need to play within themselves. They're young, though. That'll come with experience. I like this Groves Academy team. I think their future bodes well. There's some talented kids on the team. There's Moussa from outside. That he can do it all, this kid. Moussa. Very athletic. He can hit the three, he can drive, he can play point guard. Here comes number 2, Omar, who's into the game, bringing the ball up for Heritage. Working on Larry Mohammed. And there's Moussa, still on the court. And there's Shamarki Abdi into number 0, Mustafa Mohammed, off the mark. And there's the big shot out from out and rebound. Mohammed, whistle. A little friendly banter there between Mr. Bodden for Groves and the referee. Nice to see that people are having a good time. If it's not fun, why be here? Nice shot there by Mr. Mustafa Mohammed, an eighth grader. Ball off the mark, Moussa, nice rebound, puts it back up, can't convert. And the ball comes out, and that's number 4, Mohammed Aden. The ball is out of bounds to the blue. Groves. There's Bodden, quickly, behind the dribble pass, behind the back dribble, I should say. There's Larry Mohammed. Into Quinn, but he is outmatched there by the bigger Moussa, who takes the ball and drives, throws it down the court to number 2, Omar. Whistle, ball out of bounds. Chew. The blue men of Groves Academy, and there's Bilsik down to Bodden. Working the left side, takes Shamarki Abdi, cannot convert. And here comes Abdi with the ball, looking like Magic Johnson, drives the court. Wheels it around and Moussa at the top of the key, and he's gonna do another drive, lowers the shoulder, what's the call? And they, what, a block? I thought I saw a charge call and then a block, what's it gonna be? 2-3, and they call the block. I thought I saw a charge motion there by the referee at first. Maybe it was, and he changed his mind. It was close call. Those always are. Meanwhile, looking at the scoreboard, it's now a 32-point lead for the Hawks of Heritage Academy. Big throw down to Larry Mohammed, and he cannot convert. Griseth with the rebound, and he misses that one. His first miss from field goal range of the second half. Nice rebound, though. Less than 3 minutes to go. Heritage looks like they're going to reach that 100-point mark. Bilsik shoots, misses everything. Moussa with the rebound. Bringing the ball down the court, dishes off to Shamarki Abdi, and he is way off the mark. Quinn with the rebound, Baden with the ball. Down to Larry Muhammad. Reset to Baden at the top of the key. Over to Larry Muhammad, who fires the shot off the rim. Moussa with the rebound. He brings the ball up by himself. Will he go the length of the court again? No, he passes up to Shamarki Abdi. He lets it go. Block. Out of bounds to the Hawks. Moussa underneath, and a whistle and a foul on Bilsik. The body. Moussa will go to the line, shooting two. Will he get the 100th point? And he gets triple figures. I don't know if ticket stub holders will get 50 cents off their next purchase at McDonald's, but probably not. Moussa makes the second one, and they're at 101-66. 2 minutes to go. Baden brings the ball up. Both teams have their starters in there, although neither has a huge bench to begin with, so I think just about all the players have got here. And that's Max Griseth, who will go to the line. He's had a really nice second half today. I would say he made the difference. When he was, he had three baskets in a row. He cut the lead to less than 20. That was the bright spot of the second half for Groves Academy. Can't quite make that first one, but he had a really nice second half, a nice run there. Three field goals in a row and a free throw. And cut the lead to less than 20. And here he is with his second shot. Off the rim. Shamarki Abdi with the rebound. That's Moussa. Back to Shamarki. And he lets it fly off the rim. The three-pointer no good. Rebound goes to Reset. And he saves it to Bilsik, who gives it away to Shamarki. And then Omar Omar has it. And now there's Larry Muhammad. He can't control it. Ball out of bounds. Going to go Heritage Academy. Clock still running. 40 seconds to go. ...35-point lead for Heritage. Will they continue to try to score? Moussa drives the lane and the alley-oop off the rim. Baden ahead to Bilsik, and he doesn't quite slam it. I'd like to see the kid do a slam dunk. He's got to be able to do it at 6'5"? He had his chance there. Oh, he tries to steal the balls from Shamarki. 10 seconds to go. And the dish underneath to Omar Omar. No, that was Ahmed Aden. And the last shot, Baden, and it goes off the rim. And that's your ball game from Carolyn Groves Academy. The final score is 103 Heritage Academy, Groves Academy 68. They go to 1-16. Heritage goes to 7-5. Thank you for listening. For Curtis, Dino, and Paul Broden, our crew here, thanks for listening, and we'll see you again. Have a good night.